Taylor Swift fans better strap themselves in for some trouble this week.
Mm-hmm. Tickets for the Aussie leg of her tour are hot property. The end game to snag a seat.
She's the pop star getting fans of all ages singing and IT support technicians cowering in fear.
Oh, my God. One. Yes! Oh, my God. OK, it's here.
Taylor Swift is heading down under, ready to share her music with 450,000 Aussie fans. There's just one problem. There's far more Swifties than seats. Tay-Tay is no stranger to sold-out shows causing bedlam in the US, where millions of fans missed out on seeing her latest tour in person.
Dumb mom of the year right now, I guess. I don't know. I haven't slept, really, so... It's OK. It's fine.
Back home, Coldplay caused chaos and Ed Sheeran fans were left out in the cold. So will we see a repeat or will we manage to shake it off? Some very good copy.
Very good. Very did you come good. Up with that all by
I did, yeah.
Very shake clever.
It off. Anyway, to break it all down, we're joined by editor of Rolling Stone Australia and New Zealand, someone who really appreciates good copy, Poppy Reid. Poppy, good morning to you. Today comes with a little bit of a warning, we need to say this. We know that there's been huge excitement around Tay-Tay.
Yes.
People need to be really careful where they're getting their tickets, yeah. Right? This is the news side of this today.
100%. You need to go through the Ticketek app today. These are some highly sought-after tickets, absolutely. But you do not want to be going to secondary resellers like Viagogo and some other ones that host fraudulent tickets, that do price gouging. You know, thankfully, after tickets go on sale, we've got the pre-sale and then the general release. In September, there's actually an official resale from Ticketek, which is where you get it.
How is this organisation allowed to continue selling fraudulent tickets?
I know.
Why hasn't it been shut down?
It's well, crazy. We have laws in Australia, thank goodness, that you cannot sell tickets for above 10% than the original price, thank goodness. So, honestly, September 4, if you miss out on tickets for the pre-sale, which is tomorrow, if you miss out on Friday, then you're all good. Come September 4, you go on the Ticketek app.
It's been a long time since we saw something crazy like this with ticket sales, right?
Oh, my gosh, it's like the Hunger Games, honestly. So Amex did their pre-sale yesterday. The Amex site crashed. Frontier released a statement saying that it was unprecedented levels of demand. Mm. I hit up Frontier, so they're the promoter, and I said, I heard that there was about 1 million people that signed up for the Frontier pre-sale, which is tomorrow. And they said they couldn't confirm it or deny it, though. But you think of that, 1 million people signed up.
Yeah.
There's only 450,000 tickets.
Exactly. And some people are paying above the odds, like more than $1,000 just to secure a ticket. And you don't get that much for it. Poppy, in the past we've seen when these concerts sell out that artists will put more on. Is there any chance of that with Taylor?
I don't think so. She's doing 3 dates in Sydney. She's doing 2 in Melbourne. We have to remember we're competing with all of Australia right now because she's not going to Perth, she's not going to Adelaide, she's not doing Brisbane. We're also competing internationally too. The Kiwis, my family, are going to come over.
Yeah. It's weird, isn't it, that we're getting into a situation now where we're competing state by state again for the same talent. You think they used to come back here and just do
the whole country.
What has happened with that? I mean, you get the WA government climbing into Coldplay and the heat is on to get big acts and big events in various states.
It's got to be money, you know. There's certain states and councils that will pitch to bring huge artists into town so that they can monetize that. It's great for tourism. Mm. It's great for Sydney tourism. It's great for Visit Melbourne.
We have a celebrity producer on our show, Lockie Grant, who paid $1,250 for a ticket.
Yeah, a lot of money.
He's in row D or something. But he's got himself a ticket. Do you have any other tips to people out there who have excessive amounts of cash and don't know what to do with it?
Okay, so... Try and stay calm is my number one tip, but act quickly. So you're going to go on the Ticketek app to do it.
Yeah.
That's where you want to do it.
Yeah.
But you need to have all of your billing details sorted. You need to have your credit card details sorted. Make sure that's all in line before you even join the queue. Don't refresh the website either.
Ah.
So when you refresh the website, it can take you outside of the queue.
Oh,
so, yep, and then beware of the secondary ticketing market, which you led with Viagogo. Only the Ticketek.
You may not want to go to the concert. You may be of an age like Sarah where, you know, you think you're too old for it. But I've got to tell you.
Plucked a few greys this
come
morning.
Come on.
No, he's teasing.
No, no. Well,
I'm going to be front and centre.
I'm just saying to you that she came on our show, like the Today Show a few years ago, and played a concert on our show. We're hoping to do the same again this time around.
Always welcome, Tay-Tay.
So, so we're just saying, you know, it'd be nice to see her back on our show.
That'd be great.
What do you think the chances of that are?
Slim to
okay,
none.
That's enough. Ahead this hour.
We can always dream.
She was five. She can bring Ticket Tech to a grinding halt, but Taylor Swift may just breathe life back into our economy. Let's bring in Nine's finance editor, Chris Kohler, in Melbourne. Good morning to you, Effie. How are you this morning, big guy?
Really good.
Can the pop star really save our economy, though?
If they're big enough, yeah, they can, Carl. I mean, look, this is the thing. I mean, they can have a big impact on consumer spending. So we're talking flights, hotels, meals, yeah, merchandise, the whole lot. And the recent example of this is Beyonce in Sweden. She's been blamed in part for high inflation due to spending. And that's a sentence I never thought that I'd say. Beyonce blamed for high inflation in Sweden. But the idea is that by February, the economy will have gotten quite bad, more interest rate hikes and some problems by then. And so by then, we could really use that extra spending. And I talked to some economists last night about this, and they said it's going to be a noticeable impact come February. So that is going to be a big deal.
Well, imagine when Beyonce does come out eventually. But I mean, Chris, the thing is, we know that Taylor Swift concert are going to fill out. We know there are like countless numbers of seats. She needs to put more on for the sake of the economy, right?
Well, if she does, that would also have an impact. We're talking 450,000 seats across five shows. And because they're in just Sydney and Melbourne, people will be travelling to see her. So that is going to have an impact. She's putting on more shows in Singapore, I think, at the moment. Now, if she does that in Australia, then that is also going to have an impact. So, look, it could be that by February, Philip Lowe is begging Taylor Swift to play more shows to stimulate the economy. I mean, that's entirely possible at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm in a time warp. There is some validity to all of this, of course, but hopefully we're relying upon more than a Tay-Tay concert to fix the economy.
Surely.
Look, hope so. I mean, it's going to be pretty dire by then, Carl. I mean, I don't know. We've had 12 interest rate hikes so far. Could be 13 next week.
Stop it.
I mean, look, we need a lift. We need a lift here, and I think Taylor might bring it.
Well, the tickets aren't cheap. The point is, a lot of people out there won't be able to afford it, right?
Mm. Well, you'd think so. I mean, they're selling for anywhere between $80 and $1,200.
What?
But look, I mean, some people are probably going to be paying more than that. I mean, that's a VIP ticket. There's somebody, I won't name names, but there's somebody in our newsroom in Melbourne that paid $1,200 for a ticket this week. You have a think about who that might be. But people are going to pay it. Of course they will.
Chris, one of our own producers just paid $1,300 for a ticket, or, yeah, $1,200. But he justifies it by saying it's $30 a week for the next 500,000 months. So, I mean, to see Tay-Tay.
That's why they're the smart producers.
That's the way to go.
Yeah, I'm glad you didn't name, though. Lockie Grant, great fella. thank you so much, mate. Well, just ahead. I mean, you have to have something in order to go to a Taylor Swift concert. As it turns out, the ticketing prices are going through the roof. The Eras Tour, Eras. I don't know how to say that. Is it Eras? Eras? Eras. Is it Eras as in errors, as in an American saying Eras? Or is it Eras as in I made an error?
Oh, Taylor Swift Eras, doesn't make errors.
Anyway, I'm obviously not going. Billy, you going?
No, I took my daughter the last time she came out, but I'm... Yeah, I didn't get a ticket in time.
Who would you like to go and see if you had, one concert left to see before, you know, you can't hear them anymore?
Oh, no, probably not. She's a great entertainer, though, isn't she? That's great.
She sure is, Tay-Tay. Sarah, you?
Oh, no, I think that the tickets should go to the true believers. So I'm not one of those people that was, you know...
Agree.
I was going to say clogging up the phone. I sound like I'm about to start losing my hearing. Sorry, I'm 130. I was trying to call to get tickets.
Yeah, I remember.
Don't know how I missed
out. I
remember
when we used to have to line up for a ticket back in the... Anyway, great to see you guys. Appreciate it.
Me too.
Okay, Sarah.